everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Meg. If you've been here before, welcome back. Today I wanted to talk about why she's not staying. Okay. Right. This is the Chanel medium classic flap in lambskin with gold hardware, which I have had in my possession for what is roughly 4 or 5 months, I think. And obviously, given the lockdown situation that we are in here in Sydney, I haven't really used her much. And on the rare occasions that I did go out with her, it was mostly like to run errands or go for my afternoon walk. So I've decided that I was gonna let her go, and I'm gonna let her go back to her original owner. Now, why? This is probably gonna be sort of like a little bit of a review and a real talk as well. And I'll point out some of the reasons why I'm not gonna keep her. Now, I used to have a copy of a Chanel jumbo in what was meant to be the caviar leather with silver hardware. And I've sold that on. And the reason why I said I sold it at that time was because I was really just trying to test out if I wanted to have a classic flap in my collection before splurging thousands and thousands of dollars on them. I did get that off of the Facebook marketplace secondhand as well. And funnily enough, the person who sold me that had the same reason for buying it, which was to test out if she wanted one in her collection. So at that point, when I saw that on, I thought maybe I didn't like it because it was too big for my frame because it was a jumbo. And also, I wasn't really a fan of the silver hardware against black. But I mean, look at my Rider bucket bag from YSL. It's silver hardware. But I think it's more because of the design of the bag, because it's so classic and classy, that I felt like, oh, maybe black and gold would be a better combination. So I sold off that bag and went on the hunt for a smaller one, which would be the medium, with gold hardware. And this time around, I wanted lambskin because I had my Chanel Lax accordion in the aubergine color, which I've already sold. And I just loved the buttery feel of lambskin. And I didn't care that it was much more prone to scratching than the caviar ones. So I went ahead being on the lookout for it. And my friend Kenny would attest to this. We've been talking about this for like months and months. I think from the beginning of the year, I decided I was gonna be on the hunt for that. And then sometime, I think it was in May or April, I can't really remember, or maybe it was even June, when I did my video and talked about like what's on my wish list, and one of them was a medium classic flap in lambskin with gold hardware. And one of my friends here in Sydney saw the video and she was like, hey, you know what, I was looking at selling mine, because for her, she actually preferred her caviar with silver hardware in the jumbo. So, and I was like, okay. And she sold it to me for a really good price, $6,500, which I know sounds like a lot of money, but for a Chanel classic flap in this size that's very much coveted, that is a really good price. I even was telling Kenny, like, I feel like I've shortchanged her because I feel like I should offer more, you know? given that like something like this would be at least $8,500 in the secondhand market, at least, right? But she said no, 6.5, because that was like what I had spent on my Chanel 19, and I wasn't gonna spend any more than that. And I remember when this was bought, because we were together, we were working together here in the city, and I think it was December 2018 when she was saving up for this, and we went to the Chanel store. I can't 100% remember if it was the one in Westfield or if it was the one in on King Street, corner of King and Pitt, or is it no corner of King and oh whatever what is whatever wherever it was. I think it was corner King and Castlereagh. There we go. So anyway, we went, we bought, and at that time, I can't remember how much this was exactly at the time, like 3 years ago. I think it was around $8,500 at that time. And now this is more than 10K here. Anyway, so that was the story time part of this and how this came into my hand. Because she was like, oh, I kind of need money really quickly. I need a quick sale and I would like it to go to somebody who I know would take care of it. So I said, okay, sure. And I gave her the money. We were supposed to meet up, but because of the lockdown, we couldn't. So this is probably like around June or July. Yeah, July. So I haven't even had it for that long then, about 3 months. And because we couldn't meet up, I then decided, look, I'm just gonna pay for a courier. Just can you just send it over? And then it came. I was very happy with it initially. It was in really good condition. The only like real, there's probably one small scratch here at the back. I don't even know if you can see that because it's very minor. But inside, and this is one of the reasons why I dislike this. The scratches are inside because of this love letter pocket that it has. So there's this huge scratch there, and I think that's from the zip. When it's closed, it like hits on there, and it also does it like, can you see the dents on that area? Yep. So there's dents there, right? There's a long hairline scratch here. A scratch there. So obviously lambskin, very, very easy to scratch. A lot of these scratches were already there when I got it. And then I ended up scratching it by myself. Where is it? Here, somewhere here. I don't know if you can see that, but I'm sure some people would say those are very minor issues. Yes, but if you've paid quite a lot of money for a handbag, you want it to be sturdy, you want it to be durable, and also you want to be able to use it without having to baby it. But this one obviously needs to be babied because of it, and I knew that going into that. I knew that it was going to be like that because my Chanel 19 is lambskin. However, that one I feel like has got some kind of coating because it's much more scratch resistant than this one. This one was like, yeah. The other reason why, okay, my friend wants her bag back, and I'm actually happy to give it back to her. Well, not give it back to her, she has to pay me back, right? She's gonna buy it back from me for the same amount that I paid for it. Okay, she was even like saying, I'll pay like interest or whatever, and I'm like, no. Right, so she wants to buy it back from me, and I'm gonna let her, because number one, I've never really felt that the bag was mine, in the sense that when I carry it around, and you've seen probably some posts of me on Instagram where I've been wearing this, and I was like, you know what, I don't think it's me. I don't think such a classy bag fits my lifestyle, because I mean there are no events that I would be wearing this to, and I feel like it's too precious to be just worn for every day. I know that the trend nowadays is to wear streetwear and then a classic bag like this, like high-low fashion. But it's just not me. I've never really felt like I connected with a bag. And secondly, my friend wants it back, and if I don't 100% love it, then I don't think I should keep it. I've never been somebody who loved bags. It's just in very recent years when I've discovered the luxury secondhand market that I've started to be more into bags. But if I'm being honest, I don't go out that much to require a bag. And a lot of the times when I run errands, I just take my, I don't even take my card holder. Like, this is my card holder from Coach. It's $30, right? I don't take my card holder because my phone has everything I need. So usually I'll take my house keys and my phone, and that's it. I don't even need a bag, right? So me walking around with this, whether I was running errands or just going for an afternoon walk, I felt really fake in it. I felt like a fraud because I would carry this even though I didn't need to, just so I could put something in it. I would carry sunglasses, I would carry a reusable bag, I would carry my hand sanitizer, just because I wanted to put something in it, but I didn't really need it. Like, everywhere I went, they had hand sanitizers at the door, and I could always fit my hand sanitizer in my pocket. So yeah, long story short, one, I feel like a fraud when I carry it. I don't feel like it's my bag, even though I paid for it, even though it's mine. Second, my friend wants it back, so why not, right? If I can get my money back. Third, it's not a practical bag for me. One of the reasons why I didn't like the jumbo, even though that was a copy, was because of the second flap here. It made it very cumbersome to get into the bag. I don't like that design factor, which is probably why I actually prefer my Chanel 19, because my Chanel 19 doesn't have this flap. I don't think that this love letter pocket is functional or practical. It has no purpose for me because I can't, like, hear the authenticity card, right? This doesn't even fit in there. It doesn't. It's too narrow for even this to fit in there. So I don't see a purpose for it, right? I don't see a purpose of the second flap because I don't really put anything in that area there. It's just not me. I don't like the snap button closure on there because honestly I never button this because it's just cumbersome to do so, and then you have to open two flaps to get into what you need to get into. I don't find the Mona Lisa pocket to be functional either, because while you can put some cards in there, I have an iPhone 12 mini. This is like the smallest phone, and it is a struggle to get it in there. I would never be able to get it in there like horizontally. It's gonna have to be vertical. So I mean, honestly, if you really think about it, this is a very impractical bag to have. And for the price that they ask you to pay for it, there's my hand sanitizer, which fits in my pocket. Right, so for the price that they ask you to pay for it, I just don't think it's worth it. Why did I keep it? Because I hear on social media all the time that it's a classic, it's a good investment, that honestly, it was more FOMO. When my friend asked me if I wanted to buy it from her, it was an impulsive decision for me. Even though I've been thinking about it for months, that I wanted to have one. And I remember talking to Kenny about it while we were on the tram in Melbourne, and I said that one of the things that I really didn't like about this bag was the second flap, because it was really cumbersome. And then when my friend offered it to me, I was like, yeah, of course. But only because, like, it's like a status symbol. Like, you have a Chanel flap, right? But really, it's not a practical bag. And if this was like an investment, I would rather get my money back and put it towards the stock market, and use it there rather than have this sitting on display, like $6,500 just sitting there. Right. So that's the reason why I'm gonna let it go, and I'm gonna let it go back to its home. I even joked to my friend. I said to her, did you know that you were gonna want it back again? And was it something like you needed to borrow money and used it as collateral? And she was like, well, no, it wasn't the intention, but you know, because we've been talking about it and how I felt about the bag. And she was like, well, if you're okay with it, I'd like to buy it back. So I'm like, okay, yeah, sure. So she won't be here for very long. I think as soon as lockdown is lifted and we can travel, she's going to go back home. Because my friend loves her and I only like her. Okay. I hope that made sense to you guys, but yeah. Will I still get another Chanel? I don't know. Maybe, probably, if I would go the vintage route and get and find myself a single flap, or maybe even a mini. But to be honest, if it's like a design thing, because I mean, look at me, I'm wearing a Wonder Woman t-shirt. If anything, if I was going to get another Chanel, it probably would be along the lines of maybe a Chanel 19 walk or a classic mini or even a boy walk. That probably would be like my options, because I don't really need to carry a lot of stuff with me. Yeah. And again, given the price of Chanel, like if I or when I sell this back to my friend and I get my money back, I could practically buy two brand new YSL bags for the money that I'm going to get back, right? Depending on what YSL bag I want to buy. But honestly, if you've seen my last video, I only really want to get their monogram clutch, which is like $970 here in Australia. So I could buy six or seven of those for the money that I'm gonna get back, right? So, I mean, when I think about it this way, and I think about like what other things that money could go to, I'm like, yeah, the decision is made. It's like, it's going back, right? I wish I could say that I love it enough to keep it, but I don't. And again, if I'm not 100% in love with a bag, I would rather not have it, you know, and like make space for something else that I would love and would use and would not feel like a fraud in. So yeah, that's my video. That's the reason why she's moving on. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section down below, and I would be more than happy to respond to that. And if you are thinking about like selling your own classic Chanels, tell me, what's your reason? Let me know in the comment section down below. Bye.